Hello. I haven't really been making videos for the past 4 months, really, for a variety of reasons. The main one being that I've been living with other people, and that just makes the recording process even more awkward than it already is. So, I'm gonna be getting back into recording. I have a whole bunch of videos that I want to make, and I've been meaning to get around to, so I'm excited to be doing that again. But I wanted to make this update video first, because I feel like I've been gone for a long time and a lot has happened, but at the same time, really nothing has happened. So yeah, that's just what this video is gonna be. I'm just gonna update you on my personal life and my career life and what I've been doing, where I'm at, what's next, etc. So let's jump into that. So the first thing that I wanted to update you all on is Peace Corps, because I've been getting a lot of questions about if there's options to go back to Peace Corps and back to Botswana specifically, as well as if I will be taking that opportunity. There are options to go back to Botswana. There's two options really. One is to reinstate, so that would be going back to the volunteer's original country of service, in my case, Botswana. And then finishing out the remainder of their service. But there are a few caveats in that. The first one being that it's really looking like no one will be able to go back till January or February of 2021. The other caveat being that they would be pushing out the close of service date. So I was originally supposed to have my service end in October of 2021, but they would be changing that so that the service would be the complete 2 years that the initial Peace Corps service commitment is. Now, the other option is to completely restart the Peace Corps service process and go to a different country of service and just restart the 2 year commitment. Now, unfortunately, because of where I am in my life and because of, the fact that it won't be until January or February when we could go back to Botswana, and I have other personal and career goals that I want to work on, I have made the decision that I will not be returning to Peace Corps Botswana, or Peace Corps at all at this point in my life. This was a really hard decision for me to make because I really did love Botswana. I just felt like I was really thriving in Botswana. I was, exploring new passions, and I was doing work that I really cared about, and I had a family and home there. But unfortunately, it's just not going to work out for me at this time for me to go back because of the fact that I have other responsibilities and goals that I want to work towards. And I really cannot afford to be in limbo for an entire year, essentially, both financially as well as like for my own mental health. Like, I just can't do that. So yeah, now that we got that addressed, the other question that I've been getting a lot is just where am I and what have I been up to? So Peace Corps, when you are evacuated or you close of service, they send you back to the home of residence that you list when you initially apply. You can change that if need be, but I didn't. So I ended up back in Michigan and I'm still here in Michigan. Either way, so when I initially got back from Botswana, I stayed with my parents and my younger brother, and I stayed there for about 2 months. And then after that period of time, I moved in with my sister and her family, and I lived there for just shy of 2 months. And as of today, I am in my own place. I signed the lease yesterday, technically since yesterday. I moved in yesterday evening. And now I have my own apartment slash house situation. It's technically a house, but then the upstairs and the downstairs are completely separated, and it's made for like two separate families to live in. And so I'm renting the upstairs apartment of this house, which is perfect. It's a lot of space, it's super vintage and adorable, and I love it already. I'm not entirely moved in yet, but I do have a moving vlog as well as an apartment tour coming eventually. I just have to finish moving in and get everything situated. and then I'll post those for you. So yeah, this is actually my first apartment in the United States. Obviously, I had my little house in Botswana, but I've never had my own place in America. I lived pretty much with my parents for my whole life. I had like 1 year where I lived with a significant other, but then we broke up and I moved back in with my family. As far as like what I've been doing since being back in America, honestly, not a lot. Unfortunately, because of COVID-19, you know, when I came back, we were already in some form of lockdown, self-isolation, and social distancing, etc. And so my first 2 weeks I was under quarantine because I had traveled internationally, and then once I was done with like my quarantine self-isolation period due to that, we were still under a lockdown. And so a lot of businesses and organizations and anything fun that I wanted to do when I got back, they were all shut down and closed just for safety and health purposes. As well as like we weren't really allowed to see friends or anything like that. Since then, I have been able to see a few of my friends, which has been really awesome. I'm glad I got to see them because I missed them. And it's just kind of weird transitioning, you know, being in Botswana, you're so far away from everybody and you don't necessarily have the resources to talk to them all the time. Plus there's a 7 hour time difference on top of everything else. And then coming back and trying to like reintegrate into American society, and you have, you know, reverse culture shock. And on top of everything else, I wasn't able to do the things that I was hoping to do when I returned, or see like my family and friends that I wanted to. So it was a weird time. I have just been applying for jobs like crazy. I've applied to over 80 positions and I had over 20 interviews, mostly via Zoom. But I finally got a position and I'm super excited about it. I start in just over a week. I've kind of been finishing up the like procedures like background checks, fingerprinting, physical exams, etc. That goes into that. And so my position is actually at the County Correctional Facility, which is just a fancy way of saying a prison. And I'll be a mental health professional there. I'll be working on a unit that is specifically focused on treating individuals who have severe mental health concerns. So that's really exciting to me. It's a combination of case management, crisis intervention, assessment, and individual and group therapy. So I'll get a ton of experience in this position and I will be able to help individuals who need mental health services. So yeah, that's pretty much everything that I wanted to update you on. There's not really been a lot else going on aside from just like day-to-day life. I've been doing a lot of thrift shopping, I've been watching a lot of TV and a lot of YouTube videos. That's really it. So yeah, thanks for watching.